most part, it's worked. And everybody's always been unhappy. But you look back and you see the results, and it's positive. Things have changed, though. You talked about when I came in 1994. And boy, there was gridlock then. And we didn't like each other. I mean, I could not stand Bill Clinton. I loathed him. I mean, he'd be like, I feel your pain. I'd be like, he's lying. You know he's lying. And he hated me, too. I remember telling his chief of staff, Erskine Bowles, he said, how you doing, Joe? I said, I'm doing fine, Erskine, but I got to admit, I just hate your boss. I feel really bad about it. I'm a Southern Baptist. I feel guilty. He said, don't worry about it, Joe. He hates you, too. And he did.
But you should see them now.
Oh, stop it.
It's gross.
It's not gross.
Get a room.
Oh, stop.
Oh, Mr. President, you're the greatest president that ever was. Oh, Joe, you have the best TV show that I've ever seen. How great is my hair? It's not as good as your hair. Let's look in the mirror now. Aren't we great? Oh, yeah.
Future Republican primary voters, cover your ears. This is a lie.
It's disgusting. They are all over each other.
Okay, but here's my point.
There's a point to it.
There is a point. And the point is that even though we had a Democratic president that hated a Republican Congress, and hate is not too strong of a word, and a Republican Congress that loathed a Democratic president, think about what we did together. Balanced a budget for the first time in a generation. We balanced it 4 years in a row for the first time since the 1920s. Passed welfare reform, regulatory reform, capital gains tax cuts. And again, balanced the budget, actually paid down the debt for a few years. And okay, so there was impeachment, but it was the 90s. It seemed like the thing to do. But for the most part, we got great things done. And you know, we talk about
Despite it.
We talk about Tip O'Neill and Ronald Reagan as well. Chris Matthews has written a book about that. Think about what they did together. And they had a rule. And Tip was very clear about it. And Richard Reeves wrote about this in his biography on Reagan. The rule was they fought like hell all day, but at 6 o'clock at night, they became friends. And they really did. You know, Tip O'Neill's son said the only thing his dad hated more than Ronald Reagan's philosophy was gridlock and getting nothing done. And so there was that healthy respect that's missing in Washington today.
So when is gridlock a good thing and when is it a bad thing?
Well, gridlock is necessary. I mean, that friction, it's called separation of powers, and I think it's always a good thing. I mean, I personally, I don't think monopoly.